actually where Lloyd Chopper likes to perform.
Well, what we've done, but another hero
for us. True.
You think by smiling you can get away with this? You cannot get away with it this time.
Come look for someone if you come. Because he's still here. He said something wrong. Oh my
enemies. They're just a foul.
I'm going to be addressing two things in this video. The first part is the one where V said Ozo is a bastard for nominating her to go home, but she now went ahead to also call him an agent of evil. Then the second part I'm going to be talking about is that Erica is being dragged on Twitter for using Lekan's health condition against him. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, you're most definitely welcome. You came at the right time. Please hit the subscription button below. If you're a regular viewer, thank you so much for always coming back to watch my videos. Guys, I'm going to start by reading some of the tweets that I saw on the streets of Twitter. This person said, so Erica knew about Lekan's medical condition and still found a way to use it against him despite the fact that he trusted Erica to the point of telling her, I don't know about you, but there are some things that sorry can not resolve. Another person now went ahead to say, so Erica knew Lekan is SC and still went ahead to say those painful and insultive words to him. It be the people you open up to. Another person now also went ahead to say, so Erica used Watoni's son against her in an argument. We all thought Watoni was the bad egg. Erica also used Lekan's genotype to wish him death. Well, her kind of people does not deserve anything good. She's nothing but a con artist. If you come for me, fuck you. Let me just read this final one and then we move. This person said, week one has passed. You have not taken your drugs all day. You think by smiling you can get away with it. Erica knew that Lekan is SC. She knew about his genotype and used it against him. Be careful who you share your secrets with. Guys, the streets of Twitter are just dragging to Erica, and as a matter of fact, the elites are also there trying to support Erica. I remember this conversation, and of course it's somewhere down below. If you check, go down to my videos, I posted the video where she was insulting him, saying, I will kill you, you will die before 50, you're going to die young, oh, you're going to die alone, you will die lonely, and all those things. Although I didn't even hear this part where she said, oh, 1 week has passed, I'm not taking your drugs all day. And even if I heard this, I truly wouldn't have understood what it meant. But everybody has come to say, I don't know if they brought any medical condition report or anything, but people are saying that Lekan is actually SC. In case you don't know what SC means, SC is one of the genotypes. It's not very common. It's like SS, like just a makeshift shah somehow. So it's like SS, the same way that the sickle cell person's blood does not form, the blood cell does not form well. It's the same way that this SC person too does not really form well. So they have to take drugs to live on drugs, number one, and they also cannot do a lot of strenuous things so that they don't fall sick, because they don't have strong, you know, systems just like the rest of the people who are AA or AS. So that is what it means. So a lot of people are saying that, oh, why would Erica use that against him? Because at the end of the day, we do not know this about Lekan in the house. For her to know about him taking drugs consistently, it means that he told her that he is SC. I don't know where these people used to go and dig their information from. But guys, I don't have any opinion. I just brought this thing here so that we're going to talk about it. What do you think about this? And I'm just wondering why this thing is even coming out now. You know, some people are saying that they're just using it as a means to campaign for vote for Lekan. They also went ahead to talk about the fact that without Erica, that Lekan cannot trend. That they're just using this Erica's thing as a facade to go and make Lekan trend so that people will vote for him and feel more pity for him, you know. So guys, I do not know. These are the things that are going on in the streets of Twitter. So I thought I should bring it to you. The second thing I want to talk about is the part where V said Ozo is a bastard and that he is an agent of evil. Let me tell you what happened. So you guys remember this last week before this eviction where Big Brother shared them into two groups, three on this side and three on the other side. Ozo was the one who said that they were going to pick V on the other team to be nominated to go home. So, you know, everybody passed, everything has passed. People haven't told them not to discuss this thing. But Neo carried the whole matter. I went to download it to V that, oh, Ozo was the one that was even nominating you to leave. I don't know what brought this topic, but Niosha was the one that opened his mouth to go and tell V that. Then V was now like, oh, I cannot believe that that bastard Ozo wanted me to go home. Look at it, I'm the one that is still here, agent of evil. She now started singing song, all my enemies guys, at this point here, I'm not even going to try to be diplomatic about it, because we that we are watching, we see how V constantly nominates Ozo to go. When people have asked her, who would you have wanted to go, she said Ozo. Why? Because he's distracted. People have went ahead to ask her that, if Ozo is distracted, how come he just won himself a car yesterday? She said, oh, those kind of things happen. She sounded really bitter. I was even going to talk about it. I just felt like, oh, it's for me to come and be reading meaning and saying some things, and let me just forget about it. But how would you be constantly saying somebody is distracted, somebody is distracted because of Nengi, somebody is distracted because of Nengi, and this person happens to be your friend, and then you voted him, have been nominated him to go, then he did the same, it's just of course reciprocating whatever you did to him, and then you are there calling him an agent of evil, singing evil song to him, and also saying he's a bastard. V, at this point I do not know what to say to you, and I don't even know how I feel about it, because first of all, it's a game. And even if you decided to vote, there's no hard feelings, because you have always nominated people. So guys, so I said I should come and bring this thing to you guys, because I don't know how I feel about it. At the end of the day, I don't think that if Ozo had the opportunity to go into that room and mention anybody's name, he was going to even start with V, or V was going to be his only option. Let's also put into consideration the fact that the house were now limited to 6, and it's not as if it's entirely close to V. So if he's even nominating V, okay, we can understand. But if V wants to nominate Ozo, you can even go ahead and nominate him and say, oh, Ozo, he should go, no wahala. But constantly saying he's distracted, oh, he's distracted, I look at him, and then 1 hour, I see the way she even looks at him with disgust in her face. You know, sometimes when he sees, when V sees Ozo and Nengi walking and all, she'll just look at him with this disdaining bent on her face, like as if the boy they smell. So I don't get it. You are playing your game, he's playing his game, he knows what he's doing. At the end of the day, everybody get their life to live. Let's even talk about this V's matter, because this V's matter, I'm feeling some type of way about it. Do you guys know that V has outrightly told Neo to ask her out so that they will be in a relationship, make things official? But Neo said he's not ready. He even said that, oh, he cannot ask her now, he only has to wait till he gets out of the house. And because of that, she has said, oh, this relationship is over. She was the one that broke it the last time. She was the one that said, oh, no kissing, no touching. But she was still the one that took her legs by herself and went and started kissing Neo. And since then, she has been the one that has constantly been making the first move of kissing and touching and all those kind of things. Nobody has come here to say, oh, why are you being foolish? The boy has even said that he's not going to ask you out, so why are you being foolish and following him? Nobody has said that about you. So the way she constantly says that Ozo is distracted is what I do not get. It sounds somehow to me, I don't know how it sounds to you, but it sounds somehow to me, you're playing your game in the house, he's playing his game, or he's living his reality, and you're living your reality. Everybody should face their own. So you come in here to say that he's an agent of evil and he's a bastard because he wanted to vote you. I don't get it. Everybody voted somebody. So if the people that you voted now come to say, oh, you're an agent of evil, how is it going to be? I don't know why sometimes V just tries to, you know, spiritualize everything. The same question that made Erica stop talking to her and stop being friends with her is the same thing she did, where she was trying to advise Lekon to stop talking to Erica, and then she went ahead to say, oh, any agent of devil that wants to take your life will not get you, I reject it for you, all those kind of things. Those were the things that she said, that Ebuka even said, that Erica was like, has he gotten to that point where you be saying that I'm evil, or I have something to do with it spiritually? So I don't know why she's just so spiritual about everything. Anyways, I thought I should bring this thing to you. I know that my bias has entered this video somehow. I don't know how you feel about it, but I'm saying it how I'm feeling. And I've come to the end of this video. This is all I came to say to you guys. So yeah, like if you like, subscribe if you're yet to subscribe, and I'm going to see you on my next one. Bye guys.